Right, sir. So we are live, sir.
Good afternoon to each and everyone present, sir. I firmly believe that you all are fine at your end. I, on the behalf of Chandigarh branch, welcome all the participant viewers for today's interactive with CA Sanjay Tandonji. He will share his view on today's topic, that is COVID threats and opportunity. We have with us CA Sanjay Tandonji. We welcome you, sir. On the behalf of all the viewers, I welcome you, sir. Although we all know about Tandon sir, yet I would request our Treasurer Chandigarh branch CA Vishal Puri ji to formally introduce sir with all of us, sir. Over to Vishal ji.
Thank you, Kakkar sir. वेल आई थिंक सर टंडन सर के इंट्रोडक्शन देने के लिए स्टार्ट करेंगे तो आई थिंक आधा सेशन तो उसी में निकल जाएगा. वी ऑल नो हिम सो वेल. आई थिंक ईच एंड एवरी सी एंड ट्राई सिटी नोज हिम वेरी वेल. तो एक चीज शायद किसी को शायद ना पता हो, कम लोगों को पता हो, दैट ही इज द ओनली पर्सन इन इंडिया हु हैज सर्व द लॉन्गेस्ट टेन्योर एज अ बीजेपी प्रेजिडेंट इन इंडिया. आई थिंक ये इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग सर, सर कैन करेक्ट मी. आई थिंक ही होल्ड्स दैट रिकॉर्ड. वेल आई थिंक द हार्ड वर्किंग केयरिंग एंड हेल्पफुल पर्सन ही इज. ये सबको पता है. ड्यूरिंग दिस टेस्टिंग टाइम्स आल्सो ही इज सर्विंग द सोसाइटी सो वेल. फर्स्टली विद द श्री बलराम जी टंडन फाउंडेशन ही इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग राशन बैग्स टू द नीडी पर्संस एंड फॉर द ही हैज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड अप्रोक्सीमेटली अराउंड 1500 बैग्स कंटेनिंग राशन फॉर वन मंथ फॉर अ फैमिली ऑफ फोर पर्संस. And also during this COVID time, he is making face masks at his home with the Sarupas and Patkas that he has received during this last 1 year, and is distributing them to the needy persons, to the general public at large. And I think approximately 1 lakh masks has been distributed by the sir. So does he has distributed the hand sanitizers to the persons in the Chandigarh. And also, as he is well connected with the upper circles, and he as in charge of the Madhya Pradesh BJP during this COVID, all the things that are going on, he is reporting daily to central leadership and after talks with the Madhya Pradesh district heads, the BJP over there. And he is also holding such interactive meetings with the government of India officials along with the business community over here. And he is also helping the local persons with the administration if they have any problem. So he's helping day and out during this COVID time also, even though he may not be possible for him to go out physically, but over at his office at home, he's doing such things. And the one thing that I like most for him is the inspirational tourist session that sir is holding from the first day of, I think, lockdown that has begun. And sir, that is the most important part, the thing that we like and would request you to continue even after it is over. So I think hum sab to sab during this testing time we have become some sort of villa kind of persons, but I think you have got some more responsibilities on your shoulders, sir. So thank you, sir, for doing so much for the society. It's an inspiration for all of us, sir. So thank you, sir, once again. Over to you, Kakkar sir.
Thank you ji. Thank you, Puri sir. Thanks a lot to describing the personality of Tandon ji. Now I invite and request Chairman Chandigarh branch Amitosh Singh ji to have delivered his welcome address and taken the charge of the session, sir. Chairman sir.
Thanks a lot, Kakkar sir, and thanks a lot, Vishal, for giving such a beautiful introduction of Tandon sir. I, on behalf of Chandigarh branch, welcome CA Sanjay Tandon ji for an interactive meet on this topic, impact of COVID-19, especially locally, nationally, as well as internationally. I also welcome all the other panelists for being part of this discussion. Past 40 days has been quite an experience for all of us. None of us, I believe, were prepared for this on 21st March. And the next 40 days, we never thought it will be the way they have been. But as they say that time is a good healer, as well as a very good teacher, this 40 days have taught us many things going forward. I think as Kalia sir just said, that Zoom has been a new invention in this past 40 days. So importance of technology is going to play a very pivotal role, not only in our practices, but overall in the economy of India also. We also learned one thing during this 40 days, that nothing is permanent. So the monetary life, which we all used to, the materialistic things, which we also were so connected, meant irrelevant for the past 40 days. So meaning of life must have changed for many of us. Off late since the past 15-20 days, most of us in our core groups must be having a lot of discussion on the economy front. As we heard about China, the kind of manufacturing hub being shifted from China, Japan took a call, South Korea took a call, how USA is taking a call. So that way we all are also having a discussion on this part, how India is going to cope up with this COVID-19, its impact on our economy. Will India be a winner? Will India will get its chunk of benefit out of this? So at Chandigarh branch also, we thought to have an interactive meet among our esteemed members. So I thank Vishal Puri also for taking this initiative. He had a talk with me. He said, let's have something connected this way. So I'm thankful to Vishal also for putting up this idea. And we thought of coming ahead with this deliberation today with this interactive meet. So once again, sir, we are thankful on behalf of Chandigarh branch to Tandon sir for sparing his time and coming over here. And we are also thankful to all the senior members of our CA fraternity of our Tri-City being to be part of this panelist. So once again, thanks a lot. And once again, we welcome you all, sir. Thanks a lot. Over to Dr. Saab.
Thank you, Chairman, sir. Now I request CA Sanjay Tandonji to have their thoughts on this today's topic, sir. Please, sir, over to you, Tandonji, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Kakkar. Before I start with my deliberation, just wanted to know from you that what is the time frame do we have and what is the schedule of, are we just going to speak for some time? Are there going to be some discussions and then question answer or something? Just sir, let me know.
Right, sir. So we have time till 2:00, sir, if comfortable to all.
Okay.
It's 12:45, so we have 1.5 hours. And I think we can have an intro with you, sir, and then we can have a discussion or a Q&A later on.
Okay. So
whatever viewpoints you want to share first, sir, you can share those viewpoints.
Right.
Then
right.
We can have one-by-one discussion from all our other panelists.
Right. Thank you, the chairman, Chandigarh chapter, Amitos, and Mr. Kakkar, who's steering the meeting. And Vishal, especially for giving some bit of information about me. And I address to all my fraternity, my colleagues, and many of them, they are senior to me. And I look forward to them for their guidance in terms of where I have reached today. Vishal did mention about my stint with BJP as the state president. So I have been more accustomed to, you know, speaking on the political fronts rather than the economic fronts. when this particular opportunity came at this point of time, I realized that while I was making number of such deliberations with the Piyush Goyal, with the Anurag, with the finance minister Nirmala ji, and Gopal Agarwal, then to and fro I've been discussing this with some of my colleagues here also, and in couple of meetings some of you have also participated along with me. Now the kind of situation which we are passing through, I'm sure nobody on this earth anticipated that such kind of a thing can ever happen. At least in our lifetime, we have not seen this kind of circumstances. It's almost a standstill. It is almost a situation where nothing was moving. I was just comparing it with the situation that you know, we would have read about what happened at the World War time. We would have read about what there were some pandemonia like SARS and like plague and other such problems. So the problems, they were partially with the health. Then a situation came, a kind of a war-like situation. In the war situation, you know, there's some countries, they are attacking each other in a different manner, in a different way, in a different circumstances, in different geographies. So it affected the certain things which happened. They affected some geographies. Certain things affected an economy of a particular country. Certain things, they affected the movement of some people in some area geographically, and certain things, they affected only the health of some of the people in some particular geography. Now the today's situation is like all such kind of difficult situations, if you put them together, that has happened in this COVID-19. You know, you have a problem like the health-wise, there is a problem. You see the problem of the economy, and not only in one country, it is across the globe. You find the movement, it is totally stopped. Not only in one country, it is across the globe. You find that the sports activity is totally stopped. Every activity has stopped. So the situation is totally different. But not to feel disheartened out of this situation. How do we come out of this situation? There are of course threats. There are of course opportunities. How do we magnify the opportunities and how do we suppress the threats? I think this is going to be a major challenge for all of us. And when I see that I am addressing a fraternity of my colleagues who are professionals, who are educated enough, who are experts in certain fields or the other, I'm sure you would have also chosen some areas of activities, how you take this forward. So what are the positives, first of all, from our local perspective? I see some of the positives which emerge as that it changes from area to area. Now you find that certain areas, even within the country, within the city, within the tri-city where we all belong to, there are certain pockets which are getting affected. There are certain not. Overall, if you see, Chandigarh is better than the rest of the places in the country in terms of the response, in terms of the health facility, in terms of the administration which is active, in terms of relatively more literacy rate, in terms that you find that at least I feel that number of us who have talked to me in this period also, they feel that we are better placed than many others in the country, in the other cities. Then you find that India is better placed in terms of other countries. What are the advantages which India had? The India, if you compare it directly with the US situation, the US was taken off guard. The people of the US, they were more concerned and more, I would say, obedient in terms of self-restraint, in terms of the, in comparison to, if you find that Indian government's response was much better than as compared to Indian people's response. So when it comes to the country as a whole, and the positives which emerged was that we saw a society was ready to forget everything and got together. We saw a society which was ready to stand up on the top of their houses, in their balconies, and their gates, in terms of beating the drums, in terms of the COVID warriors, thanking them. You found that all over the country, even outside the country, the Indians, they had done that. Then they got together in holding diyas in their hand, and they were trying to address to the sun god, that here is something which is required, the heat is generated, how we got together. And I realized that some positives in terms of the community as a whole, those have emerged. When I see it locally, what is happening, the locally it was that number of NGOs came up with the food preparation. Our own party had been running more than 25 kitchens and giving around 70 to 75,000 of packets of prepared food every day. Until today, we have done approximately 20 lakh food packets since the day it has started. So you find the NGOs working in terms of making masks. You find NGOs working for the ration distribution. You find them getting together to distribute sanitizers. You find them that they are helping out the government. So overall, you find that help flowing, people contributing to the PM care, people putting in their Arogya app in their phones. You find that from all sides, Indian circumstances and the Indian handling and the government proactive approach has been, to quite an extent, is ranked possibly number one in the world today. The world is saluting our Prime Minister that you have handled it the best. Of course, there can be some other views on how the things can be further managed. But I would say that everyone is with one word. We all of us need to thank our Prime Minister that he saved the country from a very severe problem we could have got into. Some of the people, they mentioned that the shutting down of the economy or stopping the economy or lockdown, that's it should not have been done. Now there can be other views. But the point here is, you must realize that in the countries like Spain, and in the countries like Italy, in UK, US, these countries, in terms of health facility available, these countries, they rank much above India. In our rural side, if you find sometime if a person is affected with a very small problem also, at many places, he has to travel 50 to 100 miles to possibly get reach at some kind of a health facility which is available. So the situation was addressed it in a nascent stage, and this is the position where we have reached today, and we will be better than this situation as of now. Now we have seen that from 3rd onwards, today is the last day of curfew in Chandigarh. From tomorrow, this opening is opening of the city will take place, except the 5 places which have been marked as that these will be considered as the red zone or the containment zones, but other areas will open. So now, where do we stand as of now? I find that as of now, it is like I remembered the first time computers aaye the, to computers mein koi ek virus aati thi. To virus aati thi to koi computer ke kisi usko poochte the, jo koi expert ko poochte the, to wo kehta tha ki reboot kar do isko. Aap reboot shabd se, you must be familiar with that. To mere ko lagta hai ki this is a kind of a rebooting of the economy as of now. We are pushing that button to restart it. In this period, what we have learned, in this period, we have learned that the connectivity can play a very big role. We have learned that the digital connectivity and digital ways of not only meeting and talking, but the digital ways of doing business are also very important. So all of us are professionals in our field. we need to look at what is the way to now this fraud management, which can take place, because a lot of work will shift to the digital side. You won't find many people now doing the handwriting of the books. It'll all shift to the digital side. Even we in our company, we moved from the single level license to the cloud level license. So everyone started working from home. So I feel that everyone should get familiar with that facility. That is something which is very important. The other thing which is very important is that which would be lesser use of office. Now, most of us abhi bolte hue, I think kisi ne bola ke hum log vele ho gaye hain. Mere ko lagta hai ki apne jo बेसिक डीएनए में, जो चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट्स के डीएनए में, वेले बैठना लिखा नहीं हुआ, और हम लोग वो ऐसा बैठ भी नहीं सकते. हम लोग कुछ ना कुछ करते रहते हैं. कुछ लोग, आई फाइंड द रिसीवेबल्स क्लियरेंस हैज बीन द मैक्सिमम इन टर्म्स ऑफ सीए ऑफिसेस, कि वो सबको फॉलो कर रहे हैं. हर कोई आदमी पीछे फॉलो करता है, तो क्योंकि कई बार तो क्लाइंट्स के साथ बात करने का भी समय नहीं मिल पाता, तो इस समय एक रिसीवेबल्स की तरफ बहुत ज्यादा ध्यान देना पड़ा. जो पुराने कई फंसी हुई पेमेंट्स थी, वो आप सब लोगों ने वो निकाली होंगी. उसके साथ ही साथ ये है कि ऑफिस की यूजेज और ऑफिस के बिना काम करना और ऑनलाइन काम करना, आई थिंक हम सब ने इसके ऊपर जरूर सीखा होगा. एक अनदर इसके अंदर जो प्लस आता है कि जो आपका एनवायरमेंट क्लीनसिंग इस टाइम के अंदर आपको काफी मिली होगी. आप घर से बाहर खड़े होकर देखते हैं तो सांस लेने में भी आपको अच्छा लगता होगा. तो जो एनवायरमेंटल जितने भी पैरामीटर्स हैं, दे आर ऑल शोइंग दैट वी आर इन अ वेरी गुड टाइम. एंड एक बहुत बड़ा इसके अंदर से जो विच आई नोटिस्ड समथिंग विच केम आउट वाज द इंडियन वेज ऑफ लिविंग दैट हैज बीन अप्रिशिएटेड इन द वर्ल्ड. आप देखिए, लोगों ने घरों के बाहर जूते उतारने शुरू कर दिए. लोग घर एंटर करने से पहले अपना हाथ, मुंह और पैर जो है वो धो के अब एंटर करने लग पड़े हैं. अब हाथ हैंड शेकिंग की बजाय हम सब लोग हाथ जोड़ने के ऊपर, नमस्ते के ऊपर आ गए हैं, प्रणाम करने पे आ गए हैं. सो इंडियन वेज ऑफ यू नो, आपने ज्योति की महत्वता, अपने दीपक जलाने की महत्वता आपने वो सीखी, घंटी बजाने की महत्वता उसके ऊपर आपने किया. सो आई फील के there are certain social factors which contributed in this. आपको इसके अंदर से क्या लर्निंग हुई? फैमिली के साथ आप ज्यादा समय लगा पाए होंगे, फैमिलीज के कई इश्यूज ऐसे होंगे जो आप सुन नहीं पा रहे होंगे पहले, लेकिन आज बैठ के आपने आराम से सुने होंगे. सो दीज आर द पॉजिटिव्स विच हैव एमर्ज्ड. कुछ लोग ऐसे बात करते हैं कि वो स्टार्ट ही करते कि वो सिचुएशन इज रियली बैड, सिचुएशन इज वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट. My request to all those persons is, everyone knows what is the situation. Even if somebody is trying to encourage you or somebody is trying to say something different, but everyone knows what the situation is. Please don't try to dramatize it and don't create a panic or anxiety in the society. There is an issue. We are educated world. We should understand there is an issue. There is a difficulty, but we shall come up. Who doesn't remember what happened in the World War II? In the World War II, the Japan was devastated. People thought that this country is finished. This will never be able to come up in the world's map again because they got those atomic bombs there. But you remember last 40 years back, 50 years back, Japan came up as the world market for all the electronics. So changeover takes place, changeover happens. Anybody who doesn't want to change, he gets changed over in this kind of a system. So I personally feel that this is a rebooting of the system. And we should look at how Japan and Europe came up in the early 50s and early 60s, and how they came up from the difficult situation to a situation which is now in front of us. So now if we look at what are the positives and what are the negatives out of this, because they had put it as that what are the threats and what are the opportunities, that was the topic which was given. The background, I think, is all clear to us. It is something which we should look up to now, what all can be done. So if you see the education sector, let us go by sector wise, and then you see what will take place in terms of local level, in terms of national and then international. If you see the education sector, what changes will happen? You will find that people will, because the situation till the virus vaccine is available, it is not going to be as usual and normal as you saw 3 months back. It is not going to be that way the same. So we are looking at what? We are looking at how will you send your children to school? Many people will say that it will be now the digital way of learning shall come up. You will find that the way we are talking, that is how the child would be studying, sitting at home. This is the one change which is going to take place in the education sector. In the local level, people, they were struggling to have admissions in these schools. In the school where you find that if there are 30 students in a classroom or a 40 student in a classroom, the classroom cannot accommodate more than 30 or 40. But now if the social distancing has to be maintained, how would the school run? So you can ask yourself, one or two of our colleagues, they are very well entrenched with the school managements and they know that. Now that I think it would be more on this kind of a platform, and the admissions that would the kind of I would say the plus which admission at admission level, many persons they used to feel that we are not able to get our child admitted in this particular school or that particular school, so they'll find this will be available to you now on the net. So this is a major shift which will happen in terms of education. Now, nationally also, like you will find, like supposing in sitting in Chandigarh, you want to study in a school like DPS in Delhi, that possibility will also come. You'll have a possibility of studying in a modern school of Delhi, so that possibility will come. So you will have international schools also available. So you imagine now this bar is going to be lifted. So daily going, and maybe there will be a partition in those kind of schools that you go for 1 or 2 days here, rest you study in terms of on the digital platform. So this is one area which I feel will have lot of changes. The other area I would say that is the pharma industry. Pharma industry is up for a grab now. Now, pharma industry would have the best opportunity to gain from here. They have nothing to lose in terms of this industry. All the effort which they have done in the last 40 days, I think they get that the acknowledgements for that. They have really supported not only the country, but outside the other countries also, the pharma industry. So the pharma, I would say there is a bit of an effect with regard to the productions, bit of an effect with regard to the distributions, but not much. But this drug and pharmaceutical industry, the impact is the minimum, and they will be able to jump back in the next 2 to 3 months, and they would be better than the normal days. That is how I feel. If you see the retail non-food items, non-food items, you will find the effect, because the spending power of the persons would come down. That is one. Because you will find many persons in your clients or in your offices. You will find we've been working without their active involvement. So you start feeling that what is the need of that man? So you'll find the people at maybe a lesser cost available to you. You'll find people who are globally, who have not been able to get the jobs in, retain their jobs in the world. You will find that kind of a skilled persons being available within our Indian system. And you will find that those people with high capability and at a lesser price, you'll be able to hire them. So I find that in the non-food item, which I was talking about, in the non-food basket, it will take the maximum time to recover back, because the food items, they are not affected at all, because that was the basic need which people had. So that was all the time continuing. So the other area which I find is the wholesale non-food items. That was also that will be affected in the short term. But in the long term, it will take 6 to 8 months to come back. Then comes is your logistics. Logistics has a very difficult kind of time frame, which they are severely affected. They are badly affected. They feel that nothing could have been worse than what they mentioned. They've gone through. So in the slowdown in terms of the tourism sector, that has affected them very badly. And tourism sector is not likely to be revived in the next, I would say, at least nine months to 12 months. I don't see that sector coming up. So far as the cargo side is concerned, I would say that the cargo side, that will start because immediately once the production houses, the production starts coming, then the cargo movement will begin. But the movement on the tourism and the passenger side, the traffic, that will be possibly the last one to get revived in this kind of a pandemonium. Then you find that the automotive, aapne kisi ne koi gaadi leni ho, आप सोचेंगे कि यार गाड़ी अभी नहीं लेनी चाहिए मेरे को. उसका कारण क्या है? एक तो कारण यह है कि इस समय हर आदमी की पॉकेट के ऊपर इफेक्ट हुआ है. दूसरा कारण उसके साथ ये आता है कि अभी एक सिस्टम दोबारा से रिवाइव होगा. सो इट विल नॉट बी लाइक लग्जूरियस कार्स, वो सबसे पीछे बिकेंगी. आपकी जो यूटिलिटी वाली आइटम्स हैं वो पहले बिकेंगी. यूटिलिटी वालों में आप यू विल फाइंड दैट योर मूवमेंट ऑफ दोज स्मॉलर व्हीकल्स, द टू व्हीलर्स, दैट विल स्टार्ट इमीडिएटली. बट फॉर द फोर व्हीलर्स एंड द लग्जरी, दैट विल कम मच लेटर. इन टर्म्स ऑफ यू फाइंड दैट्स एंटरटेनमेंट, हेल्थ एंड अदर सच एरियाज, that is the biggest concern. The risk of relapses, it lies in this particular side, where you have health resorts, you have this saloons, you have the barber shops, you have these massage centers, you have such kind of even to the extent, I would say, picture houses, the theaters, such kind of a thing where the number of persons in the movement is large, that would be avoided. I am really feel affected with these malls are really going to get affected very badly. So the rental market, you find, I the other day I was attending one session in which the person from Blackstone, he was talking about that the whole system which they had fixed up was they were making malls, investing in the malls and giving it on rent, and the whole system of their company was revolving on the on the monthly income of the rentals. So you, that is not only going to affect that, but even if you look at the offices, smaller offices at home will start working much better. You'll find the real estate activity would be the worst affected out of this issue. You'll find there is a one industry which I missed out is the metal industry. The metal industry, as of now, the basic manufacturing, it's all stopped. But as of now, as the automotive industry that starts moving, behind that, the metal industry is, as I mentioned, that it's a rebooting of the system. So it the first level circle has to begin. So the back to basics, this is what is being taught now. The back to basics in terms of the agriculture, we need to restart the agriculture. So I think in 1 or 2 days, we will hear our central leadership talking about on how to restart the agriculture sector. You'll find number of measures like for MSME contributes to almost like 40% of Indian GDP. The MSME is one of the worst affected, I would say, the companies in terms of this COVID. So MSME, they've been talking about that they need some stimulus. There are certain discussions which are on, which I will not be able to give the deliberations with regard to what discussion, but we are privy to this much that it is working. And sooner or later, it should come because you need to kickstart this area. There is one other area overall, which I feel what we should do as of now is conserve the cash. At this point of time, cash rich man would be the best in terms of the next 6 months, 6 to 8 months. So, कोई ऐसा खर्चा ना करें जिसकी आज जरूरत नहीं है. तो इसका आप इफेक्ट देखेंगे कि आपको एक तो प्लानिंग, एक शायद आपने जैक मा एक इन्वेस्टर हैं, वेरी पॉपुलर, वो इन्वेस्टर ने वो वहां पे बोला कि आप अपने लाइफ के कैलेंडर में से आप 2020 का साल जो है वो निकाल दीजिए. वो इसलिए कि 2020 आपका सर्वाइवल वाला साल है. अगर आप बचते हो तो अगले साल काम कर सकते हो. सो मैं एक उसकी इसलिए कोट कर रहा हूं क्योंकि दीज आर द पीपल हु हैव इन्वेस्टेड अक्रॉस द ग्लोब इन वेरियस कंट्रीज इन वेरियस टाइप ऑफ बिजनेसेस. यू वुड ऑल्सो नो अबाउट दैट अलीबाबा. सो दैट्स द प्रमोटर आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट. So what is the point here? The basic point here is कि ये साल जो है अपने आप को बचाने वाला है. You start planning for the year coming forward. You need to start planning for 2021. You need to start planning for 2022. So this is something where you need to invest your more time that how it is and survive during this period without risking yourself, without risking your company, without maintaining the minimum cost. So I feel this is something which desires the utmost attention. Then cut costs, reduce salaries, prune your manpower if it is required, because this is something which is going to affect. I don't expect that within 3 months or 6 months or 8 months, it is going to be normal. We will have to learn to live with this kind of a problem. Everybody would have a kind of face mask that will become a permanent feature like your shirt. So you will have to carry that all the time with you. You will have to maintain social distance. And the past results, they always show that even if the vaccine comes, the vaccine for the prevention vaccine will take another 1 year to come. So first of all, we need to recondition our mind that we have to live in this situation. We have to survive in this situation. And we have to cross this period too, so that we see the other part. From the corporate point of view, I have one or two suggestions. I was reading how Reliance took the decision to have their right issue. What is the reason? This is being talked in world over, that try and increase the equity in the company. Don't try to leverage more on the loan side, because that is going to affect your survival. So all these companies, there are two things which they have already done, the Reliance has done, is one is their collaboration with the face, Facebook. And the other thing is about this right issue. They are also talking about their oil sector, which they are trying to bring that new investor. Now, what happens is they are saying that by December, you find that the biggest company in the country is becoming debt-free. So I find that this is one advice which you should give to all your people, that bring, even if they have to sell something, they should bring more equity into the system. Microfinance is one area which concerns me the most, because that is an area which tries to fuel the system. Aise lagta hai jaise sharir mein se jo hai na wo khoon nikal gaya, to ab usko ek baar dobara wo khoon bharna hai. So it is a difficult task, but usko kaise karna hai, this is something which all of us will have to see. So microfinance is an area which needs to be seen, and I am sure that the good companies in that, I won't name the companies, otherwise somebody will say that I am just trying to talk on their behalf, but some good companies you need to look at and start investing in those companies. Then it is a build relationship with your institutions, with your banks. What happens is that you will get many calls that I will charge you 0.5% less, or I will charge you 75 basis point lesser, or I'll do 1% discount or something. Relationship will matter. And in this kind of a time, don't make any such moves. But another thing is where the litigation side, that is one area which will come up. Many of us, we are groping in the dark to know about what force majeure is, because many people are seeking the legal guidance on this, that what is force majeure, to what effect the force majeure can affect your contracts. So I personally have my interest in a BPO sector. I have seen that number of companies, they are talking about how the force majeure is going to affect. So that something will give rise to the litigation part. So the other aspect which I feel is the banking sector. Banking sector is the most challenging time for them. And bankers ke paas is samay confidence nahi hai wo usko paisa aage lend karne ka, because bankers ke mind mein bhi ye aata hai ki yaar maine lend kar diya, kuch gadbad ho gayi, tab kya hoga. Aapne ye sab mein mehsoos kiya hoga, kahi mere sath privately discuss bhi karte hain is cheez ke upar. To main ye sochta hu ki bankers ke liye ye bahut ek difficult period hai, but whichever one starts with, at least aapko confidence building mechanism shuru karna padega. Aapko industry ke upar confidence rakhna padega. Jab tak wo confidence niche aapke action mein deliver nahi hota, tab tak wo vyakti bhi uske upar wo us dhang se kaam nahi kar pata. So I have zeroed down couple of things in terms of the mortgage sector, in terms of the consumer credit. So that is something where we need to do. You would have seen that what happened to Yes Bank, and how that It is on a path to recovery now. It was a difficult situation which they've been going through. So that is something which needs to be seen, that none of such situation reoccurs and we do not face such problems anywhere in any area again. Then the other sector is the oil sector. Oil sector is the most difficult at this point of time. The reasons are, you know, the demand has come down. There is almost a standstill, so the demand has come down. On the other hand, their production levels, they were already high. So the oil has hit the lowest. And there are some fears that China might look at taking over some of the companies in Europe. So the other point which I have zeroed down is with regard to the pressure on the rupee. At this point of time, rupee looks okay, but it has not appreciated in the best of the years. So this is one aspect which I am not an expert on, but I feel that in this one area where in terms of rupee terms and in dollar terms, this is an area of a challenge. The other area which I feel is that I find a shift will take place in terms of many persons' position. So you find that the overall level of the persons who are at a high end, so you will find them shifting to the middle class level. So middle class level is going to widen. So what is their utility items, the consumer items, then they can fuel that activity. This is some area which one needs to look up to. I have a number of other issues, but I just looked at watch. I have already spoken for 25 minutes. So, and I find some of the faces, they may not start looking boring. So, I find if there are some other questions, but I can carry on for another half an hour. But everyone would have some questions, so the discussion would be giving us much more results. But if you want me to carry on, I can. Chairman, you can take this call.
It's up to you. I think we can have if you have shared your viewpoints, sir, majority of the viewpoints I think you have shared, sir. So we can have the Q&A or the discussion with other panelists, sir.
Definitely. I think everyone should have time. I have a lot of my senior colleagues who are there. They could be having much more ideas to share.
Right, sir.
I have a number of issues which I can talk to, but I would only say that all of us must feel that we are in a much more responsible situation as of now. We need to help the people we can. We need to fuel the engine where we can. We need to come up further with the help in the PM CARES Fund too. We need to restart where we are required. Instead of just being on this side, everyone is telling get together, but at the same time we have to maintain the distance also, the social distance also. So getting together like this, and the lifestyle is going to go in a change, and we would be rather more simplified. Har kisi ne ghar mein baith ke bartan dhona bhi seekh liya hoga, safai karna bhi seekh liya hoga, तो बच्चे खिलाना भी सीख लिया होगा. ये सारी चीजों का एक सिंपलीफाइड वर्जन हमारे पास आ गया होगा. तो मेरे को लगता है कि लेट्स स्टार्ट लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू अ चेंज्ड लाइफ विद द रीबूटिंग ऑफ द कंप्यूटर, विद द रीबूटिंग ऑफ इकोनॉमी. एंड आई वुड थैंक एवरीवन फॉर बीइंग देयर, एंड इफ देयर आर एनी क्वेश्चंस आई कैन आंसर, और इवन माय कलीग्स कैन आंसर. थैंक यू
सर. वी आर कीपिंग यू ऑन म्यूट सर. Tandon sir, we will be keeping you on mute for now, sir. So, Kakkar sahab, I think...
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Tandon sir, for your thoughts on this COVID threat and opportunity. We are thankful to you, sir. Now, I may request our past chairman, sir, Brijit, to have a word with us, sir. Brijit, can you have?
Thank you, Kakkar sir. Thank you so much. Indeed, a delight, Tandon sir, to hear your viewpoints, how we should be, you know, looking at the scenario, which is inevitably, you know, apparent to all of us, and rather magnifying the opportunities. And, you know, that was a very, very valid point that we need to look at it in a constructive way, that how can we come out of it in a much better way for our professions, on our personal lives, and for the society at large. Great insight on what is happening in different business verticals, the discussions happening on different platforms, the help that people are coming up with, the endeavors that people have shown during this tough time, not only for their own families, their own professions, but for society at large as well, which I also personally endorse strongly, should be in the endeavor of each one of us who is capable of coming forward and helping the society. Predominantly, it is being seen that we as a fraternity is being looked up by a lot of you know, business communities, friends, and society at large, because we are considered as a great knowledgeable and, you know, so-called flourishing society. So if we set the thing straight, the message goes loud and clear to public at large, which adds on to our professional image in the society as well. So definitely, it's a great insight, sir. It is always a delight to listen to you. All of us, more of us, I would say most of us are great fans of yours when it comes to your oratory skills, which is a great thing. I suggest and request all the members to come forward with their questions and the interactive session. I think it will be a great insight again to listen to everyone's viewpoints, sir. Thank you so much, Kakkar Saab. Back to you again, please.
Thank you, Chairman Saab. Thank you, Mr. Pajji. Now we have with us a senior chartered accountant, Suman Agarwal ji is there, sir. I may request Suman ji to have their thoughts or their viewpoint of on today's topic, sir. And I have Suman Agarwal ji, sir.
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Kakkar.
Thank you, ji.
Are you hearing me?
Yeah.
Okay. Sanjay ji has already explained very well all the issues. He touched almost all the issues. And I very little to say, but I just want to say one thing, that now we are, a lot of talk is being going on that India is will be having some opportunity due to this China factor. My point is that if we really want to grab this opportunity, what we should have to do? It is the major question, because in the past, what we have seen is due to our internal problems, the foreign investor shy away from India. So in that regard, I will request Sanjay ji to just take my view, and if we can pass on to the concerned, they might be also be knowing it, but I would like to just tell that there are 3-4 factors which is really problematic. One is the bureaucratic attitudes. Other is this NGT, Pollution Control Board problems. Then there are some problems with the labor laws also, and to some extent with the problem with the our judicial system also, because in the past also these MNCs has faced a lot of problem in our country. So my only viewpoint is that we should grab this opportunity, and we should look into all these bottlenecks which the MNCs faces in our country when they want to invest. Second thing is this COVID-19 has given a very, very good message in this society, and this is how the people have behaved, how the NGOs has worked, how all the civil society has worked. It is really amazing that we can proud of our society that in this crisis, all were one and everybody was helping everybody. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir.
I just want to add on what Sumanji has mentioned. He's my senior colleague, and I always look forward to his views. And normally in any of discussions which I have attended, normally Sumanji is the first person to raise the question. So you have lived up to your reputation, Sumanji.
No, I have not raised the question, or I have just given my suggestion.
No, I'm just acknowledging it, and it is to be taken as your plus point. So what I was just mentioning in this year, that a lot of write-ups have appeared in the last 10 days, 20 days, or many discussions which you would have seen, that India is the immediate hub for now. People are moving out of China, so India is at the advantage situation. The advantageous situation does not just arise by because people are coming out of China. You must not forget, people have opportunities in Indonesia. People have in opportunities in Vietnam. People have opportunities in the eastern countries of Europe, like Ireland, and where they have also come up. Where the, like, you know, Philippines is another area. So why would they just jump on this? We have to be, we have to cover couple of areas. One area is in terms of which I covered was in terms of the banking, that we have to become little more receptive. I'm sure Mukul would stand with me on this point, that you have to come forward to help the businessman. That is from the banking point of view. Second is that in terms of the welcome, in terms of all the states level, because end of the day, the central government does not do anything at the base level where the factory or the manufacturing hub is to take place. So that is the second part. You have to put the red carpet welcome for them. So this is number two. The number three area is that the Indian government also becoming upfront, that wherever the situation is, if you would recollect that when the problem with the telcos project in West Bengal took place, at that point of time, how Narendra Modi ji had called up Ratan Tata and brought the that Sindoor's project over there in Gujarat, and over within 3-4 months it had started working over there. So something of that kind, even our external affair ministries also, they need to pull up their socks and seeing that which are the companies which are going out of China. So there is, and at the same time, as professionals, as we also have number of connections outside, we should also try and welcome and bring those people. If I can be of any assistance in terms of any hurdles at the government level, I'm always there for all of you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot, sir. Now I request CA Mukul Bansal ji to have a few words with us on today's situation or current situation, sir. Over to Mukul ji, sir.
Good morning, everybody. It's a great pleasure talking to you, meeting to you, interacting with you. Everything has been well explained by my brother, Mr. Sanjay Tandon, very respectfully, and he has upgraded us how to live with it in future also, what will be the problems. But during this corona period, what we have learned is, instead of traveling outside, we have tried to travel inside. We cannot run away from the adversities. We will have to face them and to fight with them. And we have stood very well. Hame shant man zarur karna hai. Bahut opportunities hain. Jab man shant hoga, we can look into it. What are the opportunities against the adversities? We have to find out all those. He has very well spelled out ki bachcha ab लंदन में पढ़ रहा है या यूएसए में पढ़ रहा है या इंडिया की टेरिटरीज में पढ़ रहा है, इट इज नॉट मटेरियल. यू कैन डू इट एंड कैन एजुकेट, यू कैन हैव योर एजुकेशन. फार्मा, आई पर्सनली फील केमिकल इंडस्ट्री आर गोइंग टू बी ए हब गेटिंग सेंटर्ड इन इंडिया, लाइक फर्मेंटेशन प्रोसेसेस, लॉट ऑफ द पेनजी यूनिट्स विल कम, नॉट लेस देन 50. आई पर्सनली फील इन नेक्स्ट 3-5 years टाइम यू विल सी एटलीस्ट 50 fermentation units coming over here in India. Tourism very well badly affected and will come up slowly and slowly when we will be able to fight, because this is not the COVID-19. Ek ye 20 gal chuka hai. Mujhe lagta hai ki agar if it is a man-made, started from China, then there will be more threats in future. We will have to learn how to live with this type of viruses. हमें मास्क पहनना है, डिस्टेंसेस रखना है. अब ये स्टाइल ऑफ लाइफ बन जाएगा. जैसे 9/11 के बाद एक लाइफ स्टाइल बन गया था, एयरक्राफ्ट में जाना है तो सिक्योरिटी हो रही है, 5-star होटल में जा रहे हैं दीजिए सिक्योरिटी चेक इन. उसी टाइप से इस वायरस से डील करने के लिए दे विल बी एसओपीज बन जाएंगी एंड वी विल हैव टू अडॉप्ट ऑल ऑफ देम इन अवर डे टू डे लाइफ स्टाइल. बहुत अच्छा एक्सप्लेन किया है सारी इंडस्ट्रीज के लिए एंड एवरीथिंग. फोर्स मेजर लीगल cases are going to come and we have to face it. Bhai sahab, Tandon sahab, aapne kaha bank ke upar hume kis dhang se ek confidence level create karna padega banks ke liye taking decisions. Decision hona bahut zaruri hai. Yes or no is not material. They should take decisions and should come forward how to fastly clear the fights, whether they promote, they don't want to do it, but there should be some reasons why they are declining it. Because बहुत सारा काम इस काम के लिए ऊपर करना पड़ेगा. We have to see how we can do smooth running and easy doing of business. We have to see what best we can do it and implement further. अभी हम 60 के ऊपर बैठे हुए हैं वर्ल्ड में. I think we will have to come within a bracket of 10 to 15 or 25, not beyond that. So all those things is a land of opportunities. We have to grab them. And to see how fast we can take decisions and implement. And for chartered accountants, we all fraternity members, is going to be an ample opportunity to see your client, how you can address them about the stress in their balance sheet, about their debt structure, restructuring ke upar, new proposals. Aap apne entrepreneurs ko tiyar karo, promoters ko dekho, identify karo, ki kahan kahan, kaise kaise promoters mil sakte hain. And see how these can be implemented. Punjab Invest aaj bhi Sunday ke Sunday saato din kaam kar rahe hain. I happened to interact with the MD of Punjab Invest, Mr. Rajat Agrawal. Hats off to him. Bahut tareef karne layak aadmi hai. Kehte ji mujhe online batao kya requirement hai. So why not everything in whole of the India? It's a small thing, yeah. We can do it. It is only we will get the benefit. And बहुत अच्छी सर्विस करके वी कैन डू लॉट ऑफ द थिंग्स. वी हैव टू लिव विद दिस पोस्ट 21 मार्च 21 तक. मैं सोचता हूं कि वायरस का ही पीरियड रहेगा, कोविड को कैपिटलाइज कर लो एंड देन वी हैव टू रन देयर आफ्टर एंड लॉट ऑफ अपॉर्चुनिटीज. थैंक यू वेरी मच टू ऑल ऑफ यू.
थैंक यू.
एक राजीव खुराना जी ने क्वेश्चन पूछा है दैट कैन वी open our offices from Monday onwards.
Purana sir has asked sir.
ये question मैं अभी ये chat box में read कर रहा हूँ.
You can take sir.
हाँ तो इनका आप Monday को office जा सकते हैं 7 बजे से लेके शाम के 7 बजे तक offices खुले हैं. आपके लिए गाड़ी जो आप use करोगे वो गाड़ी का number कल 4 तारीख है तो even number होना चाहिए. This is one thing which is you will have to see. एक गाड़ी के अंदर 3 लोग से ज्यादा नहीं होने चाहिए. अगर 2-व्हीलर है तो वो सिंगल राइडर हो. और आप अपने ऑफिस में जा सकते हैं. ऑफिसेज हैव टू वर्क विद लेस देन 50% कैपेसिटी. यू कैन नॉट कॉल एवरीबॉडी एट द सेम टाइम. एंड देयर हैज टू बी वो जो प्रधानमंत्री ने कहा 2 गज दूरी बहुत है जरूरी. So, इसका जरा थोड़ा आपको ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा. अदरवाइज इट इज ओपन. आई थिंक आप आज ट्रिब्यून का फ्रंट पेज पढ़ लें तो आपको पूरी डिटेल मिल जाएगी. फिर भी अगर किसी को क्लेरिफिकेशन लेनी है यू कैन कॉल मी.
ओके थैंक यू. थैंक्स अ
लॉट. थैंक यू सर.
ओके थैंक यू जी. तो सर नाउ आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट सीए प्रेम गर्ग जी टू से अ फ्यू वर्ड विद अस सर.
संजय गुप्ता जी के काफी क्वेश्चन है इनके बाद इनको टाइम दे देना.
हाँ जी जी सर दे दिया सर.
हाँ ये क्योंकि मेरे से पढ़े नहीं जा रहे हैं वो काफी
सारे. वी विल टेक संजय गुप्ता जी सर.
जी
कैन आई हैव सीए
प्रेम गर्ग जी.
हाँ जी प्रेम जी.
प्रेम गर्ग जी सर. आई थिंक सर
यस. कैन यू लिसन नाउ.
हाँ जी हाँ जी हाँ जी हाँ जी
हाँ जी. गुड मॉर्निंग संजय जी. मुकल संजय ने बहुत अच्छा बोल दिया ऑलरेडी. तो कुछ बचा नहीं आई थिंक कहने के लिए. बट आई फील इंडिया हैज गॉट अ वेरी बिग अपॉर्चुनिटी नाउ ड्यू टू कोविड. इंडिया हैज गॉट द बेस्ट अपॉर्चुनिटी प्रोवाइडेड वी गो टू अवर वैल्यू सिस्टम. आई विल टॉक ऑन दैट एंगल दैट इफ वी गो टू अवर वैल्यू सिस्टम इंडिया कैन बी अ वेरी गुड डेस्टिनेशन फॉर ऑल द कंपनी कमिंग आउट ऑफ चाइना. Because ease of doing business, as we say, this is the first priority, topmost necessity in the country. If we have no red tapism and this corruption system is reduced to an extent, then company will definitely like to come to India. Because all other factors are as good as in China, like cheap labor, infrastructure, everything we have got. Secondly, as Sanjay was telling about the education system, now virtual schools will be the in thing. Like in there is one Salman Khan Academy in Pakistan. He many years back he wrote that it is better to teach your children at home and send to schools for playing only. So now this thing I think will happen across the globe, that people will not like to send their children for education but just for interaction with the other children. Now in India, we will have education system, health system. We will have to concentrate on these instead of other things. We will have to concentrate on health system and education system because this will be, I think, the area where we can really surpass the other countries. And opening of more educational institutions, good universities, IITs, IIMs, that will be one thing that we will have to consider. I think that should be the theme for coming year. Rather coming decade for the India. Thank you.
Thanks, Garak sir. Thank you. Thanks a lot, sir. Now I request Sanjay Gupta ji also. He is
unmuted.
Much on the chat side. So, sir, have a few words with us, sir. Definitely, Sanjay Gupta ji, please, sir.
Thank you, Sanjay sir. बहुत मुद्दत के बाद मौका मिला है one to one interact करने का platform पर. We really get update from social media. मैंने तो सिंपल सिर्फ संजय सर से एक थोड़ी सी गुजारिश की है जानने के लिए एज एन इकोनॉमिक इंटरेस्ट कि ये क्रूड ऑयल की जो फॉल्स हैं उससे इंडिया की एडवांटेजियस पोजीशन क्या है सर. गैसेस को लेकर, क्रूड ऑयल को लेकर हमारे पास क्या इन्वेंट्रीज कैरी करने के लिए, कितने दिन की हम इन्वेंट्रीज कैरी कर सकते हैं, क्योंकि पीछे एक ऐसा फियास्को न्यूयॉर्क में एमसीएक्स के सेटलमेंट में हुआ कि डिलीवरीज को डिलीवर ना करने की कंडीशंस पर बायर्स को अपना सौदा 3,000 रुपए पर बैरल नेगेटिव में काटना पड़ा. तो क्या उस तरह की एडवांटेजियस पोजीशन इंडिया जैसे मुल्क को जिसमें कि हम नेट ऑयल इम्पोर्टर्स हैं, हम कितने दिन की इन्वेंट्री कैरी करते हैं और हमारा सालाना बिल ऑयल इम्पोर्ट्स का क्या है और आज की डेट में उसमें कितना सब्सटेंशियल सेविंग हम कर पाएं? ये छोटा सा एक इकोनॉमिक क्वेश्चन है.
ये पहली बात, थैंक यू संजय जी, आपने ये सवाल पूछा. दूसरा ये है कि आई एम नॉट एन एक्सपर्ट ऑन ऑयल. तीसरा है कि व्हाट एवर आई नो अबाउट इट गोज विद द, you see there is a weak domestic demand for this. When the prices went down, at the same time even your aapki khapat bhi us samay wo kam ho gayi. Aapne jo abhi likha hua tha sawal, aapne shayad pura apna bola nahi hai jitna aapne likha hua tha. Main koshish kari thoda sa usme padhne ki. Aap dekhiye ki Indian reserves jo hain, ye jo pichle, आज हम 475 यूएस बिलियन डॉलर के ऊपर हम लोग खड़े हैं. दिस काइंड ऑफ रिजर्व वी हैव नॉट सीन स्पेशली इन द लास्ट 12 इयर्स. सो देयर इज अ पॉजिटिविटी इन टर्म्स ऑफ दिस थिंग एंड द ऑयल सेक्टर. ऑयल प्राइसेस आर नॉट लाइकली टू ग्रो फॉर वन और टू रीजंस. One is domestic demand and the global demand is not likely to rise to the same level in coming 1 year at least. So there is not much looking forward to that. The second part is which you mentioned, that how those forward contracts, they had to be cancelled you know, that just happened over a day. The people who deal in the stock market, they would know that sometimes this kind of a situation comes when you have to cancel it in the reverse manner. And wo 50 cents ke upar jaakar wo logon ko aisa laga ke jaise $1 ya 50 cents wo barrel ka bik gaya, wo bika nahi hai, wo saude ki cancellation thi. I'm sure you are able to understand that. वो उस तरह की चीज कोई इंडिया में होने वाली नहीं है. आई एम नॉट हैविंग द फिगर्स विद रिगार्ड टू व्हाट इज अवर डोमेस्टिक इंपोर्ट विद रिगार्ड टू ऑयल, अदरवाइज आई वुड हैव शेयर्ड दैट विद यू. अवर फ्रीक्वेंटली वेरी स्मार्टली वी हैव स्टार्टेड मूविंग टूवर्ड्स द ऑल्टरनेट एनर्जी साइड ऑल्सो. सो यू विल फाइंड दैट इन नेक्स्ट टू ईयर्स द डिमांड which has, I would say, the peak of the demand would be the month of February. So that if there from that peak, we would not be able to reach that peak for another 1 year. So then we have an alternate sources. What are those sources? How we can do that? And regarding the figure, I can come back to you after checking up with the oil ministry.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thanks a lot, sir. Thank you. Now I would request CA Tarsem Garg ji to have a few words with us.
Good afternoon. Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
we are not seeing.
Yeah, you. My video is, I think there's some defect in my video. Otherwise, I just want to
imagine your face, sir. Please carry on.
Mr. Tandon rightly said that there is a war against Corona, and we have to fight it. With not a such as so many riders, we have to take it head on. We have to fight it boldly. Like whatever you have mentioned, I think we have to redraw our businesses. We have to divide into the small modules and outsourcing and then combining it. That will be the capability. That should be the capability of the entrepreneur, the business. Regarding your one thing, you said that the strategy of relying more on the equity and on the loan, and you have given the example of the Reliance, that they are adopting a very good strategy. In my opinion, that's the worst strategy they are adopting. If they are not confident to earn even 8% of interest and are not in a position to leverage their profits, how they will make a profit for the equity holder? It means they are thinking that the equity is free and they want to use it. Ultimately, equity holder, small equity holder, he will also go buy the take a loan from the bank or use its saving resources and put the money over there. I think we should denounce this. This is not a right strategy, and if we have to, this is not in the nation interest. If there will not be offtake from the bank or so much loan that will be substituted by the equity, I don't think the production level and other GDP level will go up.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot.
Can I answer this?
Yeah, sir.
Tarsem ji is one of our senior most members. I have huge respect for him. And Tarsem ji has also been doing number of issues work since we were starting to open our practice, and we used to look forward to his MTM financial consultants. So I remember those days. So that is why I think he has more experience on that side. But Tarsem ji, my point of what example which I took from Reliance, my example wanted to work on more on the proprietary, more on the partnerships, more on the smaller companies that you need to be dependent on that. Because anybody in today's time, he needs to be more concerned with that, what is the equity structure he's got. And why today the banks would also come forward to those people who have leveraged their equity more than their funding options. So maybe for Reliance, what you are saying that they feel that particular equity is available for free, and if they cannot service the 8%, that means they want to service the equity that at even lesser. Now you see that if the rate of that particular share is say 1,000, 1,200, 1,300, he is in a position to get that and service only the par value of the share. So to that extent, he is taking the advantage as a businessman. I'm not there. I'm not devil's advocate here to support that thing. But I think he's done a smart move from his own point of view. It might be of some as a case study, we might differ on that. But my request and my guidance would be on all smaller segment, we should try and leverage on more capital.
Yeah. Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot. Now, I would request CA Baldev Garg to share his views, sir. Over to Baldev Garg, sir.
Thank you, Shakti sir. Thank you. First of all, good afternoon to all of you. First of all, I'm thankful to the Chandigarh branch for arranging this beautiful, you can say, interaction with our leading local light, Sri Sanjay Tanjanji, at this, you can say, Sunday afternoon. Rather, I joined late because I was watching the Mahabharata serial, the Upadesh of Krishna ji. So, almost, otherwise also, I have listened full to the Sanjay Tandon ji, Mukul ji, and Prem Garg ji, all our colleagues. But I would like to say, after listening so many things, I would like to say two, three things which are in my mind. That first of all, we have a very strong leadership. When the leadership is strong, ultimately, the resources does not matter. एक गरीब परिवार होता है अगर उसके परिवार में लीडरशिप अच्छी है तो कम रिसोर्सेज से भी बहुत तरक्की कर लेता है तो हमारे लिए आज इंडिया में सबसे बड़ा जो पॉजिटिव फैक्टर है वी हैव ए वेरी स्ट्रांग लीडरशिप वेरी प्रोएक्टिव लीडरशिप और इस सिचुएशन में जो हमारी रेपुटेशन ऑल ओवर वर्ल्ड बन के आएगी आफ्टर दिस यू कैन से कमिंग आउट ऑफ कोरोना लाइक The world will know that India को हम अभी तक कुछ समझ नहीं रहे थे हम यही समझते थे गरीब मुल्क है इनके पास रिसोर्सेज नहीं है इनके पास कैपिटल नहीं है बट उसके बाद जब हम निकल के आगे आएंगे तो सबसे बड़ा हमारे पास यही आएगा वी विद द लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेज विद आवर स्ट्रेटजी एंड मैनेजमेंट आवर पोलिटिकल लीडरशिप हैव डन द ग्रेट जॉब तो कीपिंग इन व्यू दैट दूसरा उसके बाद होता है रेपुटेशन Reputation depends from the family, reputation of the professional, reputation the same way, reputation of the country. Abhi tak from the last 30 years, we have seen the China. But China ke case mein, jab hum reputation ki baat karte the, wo yahi kehte the, maal kahan ka hai China ka? China ka maal hoga ji, ye maal duplicate hoga, ja isme quality nahi hoga. But India ke case mein, through this pandemic, You have seen, भी हमें चाइना की किट्स भी वापस करनी पड़ी तो इंडिया की एक रेपुटेशन है सेकंड स्ट्रॉन्ग पॉइंट हमारे लिए ये है और थर्ड पॉइंट जो हमारे सभी के ऊपर जिम्मेवारी है वो ये है भी इनफैक्ट फॉर एवरी एक्शन भी हम गवर्नमेंट को कोसते हैं पॉलिटिकल लीडरशिप को कोसते हैं बट आई बिलीव एंड आई थिंक वी आर ऑल प्रोफेशनल वी शुड फाइंड आउट द वेज एंड मीन्स हाउ टू रिजॉल्व द इशूज And through leadership at the local leadership, at the state leadership, and at the center leadership, we should continuously pursue the things to make that better in the interest of the society. Or ye do teen char cheeze agar hum kar lete hain, I don't feel any doubt. Agar hum kisi jagah pe piche rahenge. Innovation hamari bahut takdi hai. You have seen in the last 2-3 months. I have seen so many persons are making a ventilator. Jo kabhi hum ventilator ki baat nahi soch sakte the, aaj hum ventilator banane lage hain. The other factor is also oil factor is in our favor. Jaise Sanjay ji ka question tha, uske liye main kahunga jo oil factor hai, wo hamari favor mein hai aur kuch hamari favor mein nahi hai. Favor mein ye hai ki isse in last year India imported the oil of $102 billion. At the average price of around $50 per barrel. So now the import bill will depend upon the price in the future. And I believe there will be a cut of around 40% in our import bill of the oil. Or oil bill ka import kam hone se, we will be affected with the exports also. क्योंकि जो गल्फ कंट्रीज को हमारा एक्सपोर्ट होता था वो एक्सपोर्ट की हमारी डिमांड कम होगी, उसमें आप राइस फैक्टर लगा सकते हैं, जो भी गल्फ को हमारी आइटम जाती थी, वी हैव टू कीप वॉच ऑन दोस थिंग्स। उसके बाद आता है, संजय जी ने कहा था बैंकिंग, बैंकिंग के लिए चैलेंजेस हैं, बट बैंकिंग के लिए नाउ द बैंकिंग विल बी डिफरेंट इन द पब्लिक सेक्टर एंड द प्राइवेट सेक्टर। नाउ इट इज टाइम ऑफ द पब्लिक सेक्टर टू कम अपॉन, क्योंकि जो अभी तक क्या था, फ्रॉम द लास्ट 5 to 7 years प्राइवेट सेक्टर में लोन चीप हुआ था, अब वो लोन चीप की बजाय पब्लिक सेक्टर में चीप हो गया। व्हेन यू सी द एग्जांपल ऑफ द एसबीआई, नाउ एसबीआई हैज द लोएस्ट रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट प्रोवाइडिंग इन द हाउसिंग लोन बिकॉज दे आर गेटिंग द चीप फंड्स। इन केस ऑफ बल्क डिपॉजिट, जो एसबीआई का डिपॉजिट रेट है दैट इज अराउंड 3.25 or 3.3, that's why SBI is reducing because that is also reputation. Everybody with the big money is thinking that first of all I have to save the money, not for the return. So in the future I am very hopeful about the country, the progress, but only thing I will, that the God bless to our leadership, because the leadership has started the way, the things have started very tremendous and very sincere. But at the grassroots level, we people also should make our clients to the compliance level, to the real and factual position. Because I remain in the bank for 3 years as a director, as a central auditor, but it is very difficult for the banker to know which is genuine and which is not genuine. So ultimately, that comes the responsibility of the professional. If we support the genuine persons, ultimately there will be no problem in the coming time to get the finance and other. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Garg sir. Thanks a lot, sir. Thanks, everyone. Sir, first of all, I want to ask everybody, all senior members are on participant. Anybody who wants to speak or share his or her view are most welcome on this platform. And going ahead, we have with us Naveen Soni ji also. I would request Naveen Soni sir to have their view on this current situation, sir. Over to Soni sir.
Yes. Sanjay sir, namaskar and good afternoon to everyone. I have one suggestion which I am seeing that ab hamare offices aur choti moti jo industry khul rahi hai uske liye availability of labor ki sabse zyada problem aayegi. To kafi labor migrate kar chuki hai ya kar rahi hai. मेरी जो सजेशन थी कि लोकल लेवल पे एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन लेवल पे एक हमारा लेबर रिक्वायरमेंट की रजिस्ट्रेशन और अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ लेबर की एक सेक्रोनाइज सिस्टम बनाया जाए कि जो लेबर माइग्रेट होके हमारे एरिया में आ गई है वो हमारे लोकल लीडर जो एमसी हो, पंचज हो, सरपंचज हो या और एजुकेटर या एनजीओ हो, वो लेबर को काम दिलाने के लिए उनकी एक ऑनलाइन रजिस्ट्रेशन करें और जो इंडस्ट्री को, जो स्मॉल बिजनेस को, जो हमारे इकोनॉमी की मेन बेस है, जो अब खुलने जा रहा है कि अब हमारे ऑफिस में भी लेबर की दिक्कत आएगी, लेबर माइग्रेट कर चुकी है, उस रजिस्ट्रेशन से अवेलेबिलिटी कॉन्ट्रैक्टर बेसिस पे अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ लेबर हो जाए। फॉर एग्जांपल आज मुझे 10 लेबर चाहिए जो माइग्रेट कर चुकी है, मैं एसेंशियल गुड्स में भी हूँ, अब मेरी इंडस्ट्री खुल रही है तो मुझे अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ लेबर मेजर प्रॉब्लम आने वाली है। यदि हमारे लोकल लीडर या लोकल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एक ऐसा पोर्टल बना दें जैसे कि आपका एसएस है, इस पोर्टल में जो लेबर अवेलेबल है वो अपने आप को रजिस्ट्रेशन करा लें और मेरी जो रिक्वायरमेंट है जहाँ मैं उनके कॉन्टेक्ट नंबर आ जाए ताकि मैं उनको कॉल करके अपना काम भी स्टार्ट करा सकूँ और लोकल लेवल पे हमें लेबर की प्रॉब्लम भी खत्म हो जाए, उनकी भी हेल्प हो जाए और इंडस्ट्री की भी हेल्प हो जाए।
I'll convey this to the government.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Sir, Shiv Gupta ji.
Sir, good afternoon, everybody.
Yeah.
So Sanjay ji ne detail mein explain kiya hai sab cheez ko. But I would like to add something more. That is over and.
Shiv sir, if possible, kindly switch off your video, sir. I think there is some bandwidth issue. If you can just switch off your video.
Down is the profession is going to face. We will have to think longer. And one thing more set up over.
Shivshar, your voice is not audible. In the meanwhile, I would request Manmohan Garg-ji to say a few words.
Garg-sahab. Hello, everyone. Good afternoon, Sanjay-ji. Meeting after a long time through this facility. I am really thankful to our Chandigarh branch for this arrangement. And I listened to all the views. My personal view is that MSME and retail shops are going to get affected very badly. More probably food industry, restaurant and hotel industry, and also education service sector will be getting affected. So I request from platform Sanjay Tandonji to get this message conveyed that immediate relief and care is required for this sector. Thank you and wish a very speedy recovery from this COVID corona problem. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir. Thanks a lot. I would request Mukulji, you have raised the hand.
Yeah. I was just to continue with my old discussions and to communicate to Mr. Baldev Garg and to all of us. Ye hamare paas मुझे लगता नहीं कि हमारे पास कैपिटल की कोई कमी हो. वी वर ए गोल्ड एरा था, गोल्डन एरा था, और आज आने वाला भी गोल्डन एरा ही है. आज कई बार वी हैव लर्न फ्रॉम द पास्ट कि मेनी टाइम्स व्हेन वी हैव रेज द वॉइस, आवर लीडर्स हैव रेज द वॉइस, द पीपल हैव कंट्रीब्यूटेड लाइक एनीथिंग. आज हम कुछ ना करें, पहले भी मैंने किसी प्लेटफॉर्म पे ज्वाइंट सेक्टर में बीजेपी के जो हमारा ग्रुप चल रहा है उसमें कम्युनिकेट किया था कि सिर्फ अच्छे अच्छे मंदिर और ट्रस्टीज को पकड़ लिया जाए, उनसे कहा जाए कि अपना गोल्ड डीमोनेटाइज करा लें. दैट मनी इज गुड एनफ एज कैपिटल टू रेज इंडस्ट्री, एज कैपिटल एज ह्यूज मनी इज अवेलेबल. व्हाट इज रियली रिक्वायर्ड इज कि जैसे रिजर्व बैंक ऑफ इंडिया ने मार्च एंड में रिलीफ पैकेज लेकर आए, रेपो रेट 0.75 बेसिस पॉइंट कम किया, CRR 1% कम किया. No bank has come forward to pass on to the consumer except SBI, that too from effect of 10th of April to the extent of 35 basis point. Ek hame message dena bahut zaruri hai, decisions lena bahut zaruri hai, ki how fast we can really act upon and pass on to the consumer. That is all briefly I was just to say for Mr. Baldev Garg also. Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot, Balsa. Thanks a lot. Tandon sir, there was one question from Umakant sir. He wanted to ask that my question is, as Congress and BJP, especially Kiran Kher, has criticized the decision of administration and probably administration is going to back foot. What is your view to say about opening of curfew as well as lockdown in Chandigarh from 4th May to 2020, sir?
I have not read anything what she has said.
There was a tweet of Kiran Kherji in which she have criticized a bit that we are going a bit fast on this issue.
Or sir, we can ask every individual has his view and everyone is allowed to give his view. I'm sure there are certain information which are either not available or which the I have opened this thing. There is no tweet.
Sanjay sir.
Umakant sir is online.
I've just opened this thing.
Sir, abhi faisla wapis ho gaya sir. Faisla wapis ho gaya abhi. Abhi faisla wapis ho gaya. Office ka kal hoga faisla naya ki khulna ki nahi khulna, wo kal faisla hoga. हाँ. आपने काफी अच्छा कवर किया है सारा कुछ, बहुत बढ़िया किया कवर. लेकिन मेरा सिर्फ यह कहना था कि कांग्रेस भी विरोध कर रही थी, बीजेपी भी विरोध कर रही थी किरण खेर के तौर से. अभी फैसला वापस हो गया कि कल सुबह डिसाइड करेंगे कि खोलना कि नहीं खोलना.
कल सुबह क्या हो जाएगा डिसाइड, मतलब ये रात से लेके सुबह तक कोई सर्कमस्टांसेस बदल जाएंगे?
I think maybe sir the administrator might want to come up with some new guidelines on this.
नहीं अगर अगर कुछ ऐसा आया है मेरी नॉलेज में नहीं है. I'll find out.
15 मिनट पहले आया सर. 15 मिनट पहले.
Can you share that in the some group?
हाँ जी बताओ किसे मैं अभी कर देता हूँ जी.
I think BJP group में डाल दो सर.
BJP group में डाल दो.
ये एक
Vineet sir, I have unmuted you. You wanted to say something?
Yeah. दैनिक भास्कर का आया है ये कि चंडीगढ़ में छूट का फैसला रोका. सोशल मीडिया पे विरोध के बाद शहर में छूट देने के फैसले को वापस लिया गया. सोमवार को MHA के देशों पर दोबारा फैसला लिया जाएगा. ये दैनिक भास्कर का आ चुका है ये ब्रेकिंग न्यूज. इसका मतलब काफी ठीक ही होगा अगर दैनिक भास्कर ने लिखा भेजा ये.
हो सकता है ठीक होए. मैं आई डोंट हैव दैट इंफॉर्मेशन. मैं काय को कंटेस्ट करूं उस पे. लेकिन
चलो अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस कर्फ्यू जैसे अभी संजय सर मेरी जैसे अभी मुकुल सर ने बोला कि रिलीजियस प्लेसेस के पास काफी सारे थाउजेंड एंड लैक्स ऑफ रोड के फंड्स भी हैं, गोल्ड भी है, लैंड भी है जो अनयूटिलाइज्ड पड़ी है. क्यों ना ये वाले फंड्स किसी भी तरीके से जैसे गोल्ड है गवर्नमेंट इसको कुछ नेशनलाइज करे, कुछ करे, इसको मेडिकल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर डेवलप करने के लिए किसी पर्पज के लिए क्यों ना हम यूज कर पाए. मतलब ठीक है इसके ऊपर विरोध भी काफी होगा. मैं ये नहीं कहना चाहता कि ये ऐसा ही होना चाहिए. कैन वी हैव अ नैरेटिव ऑन दिस टॉपिक इन द टाइम्स टू कम.
व्हिच मनी
जो हमारे रिलीजियस इंस्टीट्यूशंस के पास काफी सालों से पड़ी है. रिलीजियस बहुत बड़े बड़े रिलीजियस इंस्टीट्यूशंस हैं उनमें गोल्ड है, टन्स ऑफ गोल्ड है, लैक्स ऑफ करोड.
अब देखिए
नहीं जस्ट नैरेटिव होना चाहिए. मैं नहीं अगर कहता होना ही चाहिए.
नहीं होना. दिस इज अ वेरी बिग इशू विच यू हैव जस्ट टच्ड. दिस इशू इज नॉट अ स्मॉलर इशू. व्हाट हैपेंस इज लाइक व्हेन यू गो टू द टेंपल यू ऑफर योर मनी और योर प्रॉपर्टी और समथिंग फॉर दैट टेंपल्स वर्क. Now what happens is now it happened in Andhra Pradesh for that Balaji's temple. That money was put to use for some कि आप हर religion के अंदर वो दीजिए. अब वहाँ पे एक बार ये point खड़ा हो जाता है कि यार हमने जो है ये मंदिर ने सारे religions को खड़े करने का क्या वो contract लिया हुआ है. So you have to ये वाला जो issue है कि जी वो अपना liquidate करें, उनकी अपना trust है, उनका अपना है. आप किसी और जो इंस्टीट्यूट हैं, जो पूजा के स्थल हैं, किसी और को सजेस्ट तो करके देखो वो आपको क्या जवाब दे. ये हमारे पास ही है. हमारी इतनी वो ओपन है कि जो हम लोग ये कर लेते हैं. बट ये टॉपिक को आप अवॉइड ही करें तो बेहतर है.
Right sir. I think sir one question. Sorry. From Navneet Gupta ji wanted, but I believe he have left.
Shall we wrap up?
Right sir, I believe so. Any other questions sir? If so, we can take up. Otherwise, we can conclude.
I'm always available for any other questions.
Sir, before we put up our vote of thanks, sir, any closing remarks from your side, sir, Kannan sir?
I think it's a very good effort by the chapter to put everyone together. Today you gave me the chance to speak. I think there are a number of other distinguished people within our professional group here who can also take on this thing. And I would request that such kind of a thing should be made a regular time frame, that you give one topic, but don't make it longer than 1 hour, because I find lot of people out of wo beech mein se uth ke gaye honge. I'm sure koi bathroom gaya hai ya koi beech mein kahin aur apna kaam dekh raha hai, beech mein phone sun rahe hain. तो इसको रखो 45 मिनट्स टू 1 आवर, 15 मिनट एक आदमी अपना व्यू रखे, उसके बाद 15-20 मिनट के क्वेश्चन आवर सेशन हुए और 15 मिनट का आपका फॉर एनी कंटिंजेंसीज आप वो ऐड रखें। तो इसको आप अगर वीकली फीचर रखते हैं तो ये डिजिटल साइड में जाने की तरह, कभी कोई जीएसटी का इशू ले लो, कभी कोई ये बैंकिंग का इशू ले लो, कभी कोई ऐसे ये ऑयल सेक्टर का ले लो, कभी कोई और एजुकेशन सेक्टर का ले लो, और वी हैव एक्सपर्ट्स विद इन आवर सेल्फ। सो दैट इज माय सजेशन टू यू, क्योंकि आप थोड़ा डिजिटल साइड जाना ही पड़ेगा, मिलना मुलना तो हो नहीं पाना।
Surely, sir, surely. We will follow your suggestion, sir. And I hope that Chandigarh branch collectively will be putting up all these efforts to bring technology to the doorsteps of all our members. Sir, before we conclude, I believe Kalia sir had raised hand and Navneet Gupta ji. So only two observations from their side. Kalia sir, you are unmuted.
Sir, मैंने कुछ ज़्यादा तो नहीं कहना. I have already, we had a very healthy discussion. I just wanted to make one point. That there's a lot of apprehension that MSME will be in crisis or this sector will be in crisis. I just want to remind, when lockdown was there, people were having a lot of apprehension ki log bhook se mar jayenge. Par 40 din mein maine nahi suna koi bhook se mara hai. We have swim this period and we'll swim the further period also. Only thing is we should be positive and motivated and to fight with this crisis.
Thanks a lot, sir, for your suggestion, sir. Sir,
one minute question. I want to add that the
sentiment. सारे दाढ़ी वाले बाद में भी जाग रहे हैं।
तो
हाँ जी, please.
जोशी तो पहचाना ही नहीं जा रहा यार।
तभी छुपा हुआ था ना मैं।
जोशी जी नमस्कार, कमाल हो गया।
कैसा नमस्कार?
Please go ahead, sir.
Good evening, everyone, sir.
Sir, my I have listened all of you, sir, all seniors to me, and a lot of great discussions that happened today, and very well said by Tandon sir that this should be made a regular feature. We could meet on a weekly or a. आजकल तो sir जब तक lockdown था daily भी मिल सकते थे, but at least weekly तो मिला करें sir. एक मेरा session है sir, by using your good office sir, जैसे काली sir ने भी कहा कि MSME का sir sentiment of the businessman is very down. सर एक हम ये बात कर रहे हैं कि वी शुड हैव ए होल्डिंग ऑफ कैश फॉर अवर नेसेसिटीज आल्सो एंड इफ ऑल पीपल स्टार्ट होल्डिंग ऑफ कैश द बिजनेसमैन द प्रोफेशनल्स द मिडिल क्लास देयर विल नॉट बी मच डिमांड लेफ्ट इफ द डिमांड इज नॉट देयर द इकोनॉमी इज नॉट गोइंग टू रीस्टार्ट अगेन सो माय सजेशन इज दैट और हमारे सर ये भी एक देखा गया है सर हमें आई हैव अ वेरी स्ट्रांग बिलीफ ऑन माई लीडर हमारे देश के जो लीडर हैं वो बहुत अच्छा एक आइडिया लेके आएंगे चाहे वो 50,000 करोड़ का आरबीआई ने दिया चाहे वो 1,70,000 करोड़ रुपए हमने अपने उसके लिए दिए लेकिन एमएसएमई के लिए बहुत ज्यादा वेट करवाई उसकी पेशेंस को चेक कर रहे थे या क्या कर रहे थे अभी तक भी कोई पैकेज डिसाइडेड नहीं है और अगर वो 50,000 करोड़ का भी सर वो कुछ आया भी तो वो जैसे सर ने भी एक बार पॉइंट आउट किया कि एक्चुअल रियल टर्म्स में वो पैसा एमएसएमई को नहीं मिलेगा इवन लोगों की क्रेडिट कार्ड की लिमिट्स भी जो है वो अगर 2 लाख थी तो 1 लाख कर दी गई है तो सर एक्चुअल में अगर पैसा ही नहीं आएगा हरीश सर्वे जी भी उस दिन कह रहे थे कि ये टाइम ऐसा नहीं है कि हम ये सोचें कि हमें अपने बिजनेसमैन को ट्रस्ट करना पड़ेगा हमें जो है कंपनी के अंदर पैसा डालना पड़ेगा अगर सर आप अपने गुड ऑफिसर्स से ये मैसेज दे सकते हैं कि जो पॉलिसीज डिसाइड हो उनकी इम्प्लीमेंटेशन भी उतनी स्ट्रांग हो हमारे यहाँ पर सर बजट से एक्सपेक्टेशन मिडिल क्लास को और लोगों को बहुत ज्यादा रहती है लेकिन वो बजट उस तरीके का आता नहीं है क्योंकि वी सपोर्ट अवर लीडर वी सपोर्ट अवर पार्टीज हम उस चीज को जरूर एक एज ए हेड ऑन लेते हैं कि हाँ हमारे देश को इन चीजों की जरूरत है तो ये पॉलिसीज जो है आनी चाहिए लेकिन सर अब ये टाइम ऐसा है अब ये क्राइसिस का टाइम ऐसा है कि सब लोगों ने देश के प्रधानमंत्री का साथ दिया है और प्रधानमंत्री के साथ से जो पैकेज आए उस पैकेज को सेंटिमेंटली भी हमें एक तरह से एनालाइज करना पड़ेगा कि जो पैकेज है वो सेंटिमेंटली ग्रो करे कि सेंटिमेंट हमारा अप रहे तो मेरा ये मानना है कि सर अगर सेंटिमेंट्स अप होंगे तो ये देश जरूर जो है दोबारा उसी लेवल पे खड़ा होगा थैंक यू सर
वेलकम
योर सेंटिमेंट्स
मैंने और सबसे ज्यादा इस दौरान पे अगर कोई भी सेगमेंट अफेक्टेड है सबसे पहला नंबर आता है, जैसे सर ने भी नंबर लिया, टंडन सर ने, मुकुल सर ने भी नंबर लिया, वो है टूरिज्म एंड हॉस्पिटैलिटी सेक्टर, जिसके अंदर सारे छोटे बड़े होटल्स भी आते हैं, फाइव स्टार्स भी आते हैं, सेवन स्टार्स भी आते हैं छोटे छोटे। और टूरिज्म में तो कई सारे स्टेट्स हैं, हिमाचल है, J&K है, सारी जिनकी GDP सारी टूरिज्म के ऊपर डिपेंडेंट है, टूरिज्म का एक पार्ट हॉस्पिटैलिटी है। मेरा सर से एक रिक्वेस्ट भी है सर, हेलो,
हाँ जी सर, हाँ जी प्लीज, सर से
जो एक MHA का 29th मार्च का सर्कुलर है जो ये कहता है सैलरी हमने नहीं लॉकडाउन पीरियड की काटनी है इंडस्ट्री के लिए, वो बात तो बिल्कुल सही है, वो हम अपने अपने ऑफिस में भी पूरी कोशिश कर रहे हैं किसी भी स्टाफ की, बच्चे की कोई भी सैलरी ना काटी जाए और किसी भी तरीके से वो सारा उनको टेक केयर किया जाए। अगर इंडस्ट्री की बात करते हैं सर, तो इंडस्ट्री क्या होता है, वो डेली रेवेन्यू के ऊपर डिपेंडेंट है, हॉस्पिटैलिटी और टूरिज्म डेली रेवेन्यू आता है, मंथली कलेक्ट होता है, उसके बाद अपन उसको सैलरी डिस्ट्रीब्यूट करते हैं। इसमें मेरी सिर्फ एक रिक्वेस्ट है टंडन सर से स्पेशली, अगर इसकी सर कर्टेल हो जाए, हम ये नहीं कहते पूरी काटें, हम कहते हैं इसको थोड़ा, जब हमारा इंडस्ट्री बढ़िया करती है तो स्टाफ को इंसेंटिव बोनस और इंक्रीमेंट भी देता है, अब ये टफ टाइम में स्टाफ रहेगा, कंटिन्यू कर सकते हैं हम, देयर इज नो पॉइंट ऑफ लीविंग दैट स्टाफ राइट नाउ, बस ओनली इज दिस रिडक्शन शुड बी अलाउड।
नवनीत जी,
जी सर,
मैं आपको बीच में रोक रहा हूं, ये इशू के ऊपर एनी पब्लिक मैन विल नॉट टॉक टू यू ऑन द फोरम। मैं इतना कह सकता हूं कि आपका जो सेंटिमेंट है वो मैं सेंटिमेंट कन्वे कर देता हूं, लेकिन आपको इसमें कोई और डिस्कशन करनी है, यू शुड टॉक टू द फर्दर एक्सपर्ट्स, एंड इफ यू आर नॉट सेटिस्फाइड यू कैन टॉक टू मी आल्सो। लेकिन ये वाला इशू हम भी 50 जगह रेज कर चुके हैं, इस इशू के ऊपर इसको आप इस फोरम पे ना ही रखें।
ओके सर,
राइट सर, थैंक्स अ लॉट सर। सो सर, now I request Upkar sir to kindly give a formal vote of thanks.
हाँ, उपकार जी बड़ी देर से चुप बैठे सी।
Just a second sir, let me unmute him. हाँ जी उपकार sir, you have been unmuted.
Thank you Amitav ji. I on behalf of Chandigarh branch of NIRC of ICI, thank you CS Sanjay Tandon ji for interactive meet on COVID-19 and his suggestions how to handle the situation. And I agree with him that priorities of everyone will be changed now. I am also thankful to all panelists, senior members for in the interaction meet and their words on the current situation. Thank you all. Thank you very much. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you, sir.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Thanks, Tanaji.
Thank you. Thank you very much.